Yeah, so I made a living for a couple of years playing poker, mostly online, mostly limit hold'em actually. But the games were really soft, I think, from 2004 to 2007. Right. So I kind of left my consulting job to go write about baseball and play poker. I fortunately got out, began to do other things before Black Friday. But no, poker is kind of a big part of my life story. Being in situations where, you know, you are under kind of media scrutiny in the elections and so forth, and this seems, I mean, I think it's not easy. I think a poker tournament's a really stressful situation, but you learn how to kind of perform under pressure. And even if you're physically tired, you're still trying to think through things. Sometimes you have to slow down your thinking a little bit. But I think that helps. It's not that there's no pressure, but it's that you're better at handling it. But the good thing about poker is that if someone's full of shit, then you call them, right? Yeah. Or you raise them, right? And in politics, there's so much politics in politics. In poker, it's about how you play your hand. Do you get lucky, of course? But they're very different types of mentalities, I think. I do think actually having played poker makes you tougher in the political climate, because you're like, look, people are going to be dumb, and they're going to be very hubristic and fool themselves about being dumb. And no matter how much you tell them they're dumb, right, politely or impolitely, they're not going to really wise up. And so, you know, in the long run, you make a bet, you lay down your wager, and then in the poker table, it's more convenient. But that's why, you know, in politics, when I kind of threatened a bet, this kind of blowhard pundit, Joe Scarborough, right? Everyone was offended by this notion, whereas in the poker community, you know, if you have a difference of opinion, then you settle it by actually making a wager and testing your ideas and seeing who's right. So it's important in my kind of psychology, I think. The key kind of skills that are mathematically based in poker are number one, kind of game theory, so you understand, am I hard to exploit in a certain spot? And number two, really, is estimation, right? Is knowing kind of what your equity is with a certain flop against a certain opponent, you know, and those things I think are good for mathematical thinkers. Sometimes the tactics, the tactical part, the day-to-day play, that's more challenging, right? So you have to kind of slow down and be more deliberate with your actions, I think. The way the kind of professional, especially the kind of high-limit, nosebleed stakes, no-limit game has evolved is very, very sophisticated, right? I think if you look kind of back at how people might have played poker 7 years ago or something, right, the kind of ABC style is actually quite bad because it's very predictable. You have to bluff some, you don't want to bluff too much, but what people wouldn't understand is that most players, maybe not anymore, but certainly 5-10 years ago, most players were not bluffing nearly enough. They're playing much too tight, not mixing their play at all. So I think people understand now that a somewhat looser and more aggressive style is not just kind of a adjustment, but almost necessary. You have to conceal your strong hands and have a whole range that you're playing in different ways to play optimally. I think it'd be hard to make a living as a tournament pro, unless, you know, the guys who are good at this are getting sponsorships, finding other ways to market their brand, so it's not pure poker. It's a tough life now, you know. I think maybe in the main event where it's both a soft field and you're very, very deep, the longer the tournament goes, the more the skill edge grows, then there are guys who are going to have a pretty high ROI. But if you're grinding out tournaments where two-thirds of the fields are professionals and you're traveling to Europe or Australia to do it, you know, I think there are very few players in the world who are really coming out ahead. No, I mean, it'd be really cool to make a deep run to win a bracelet. At this point, I'm technically a recreational player. You know, I can afford to do this, but I have other ways to earn a living, too. It would be just a really good accomplishment. You'll get so much pure competition like you do in poker as much. It's something that kind of always has haunted me a little bit. When I was actually playing for a living, I kind of never played tournaments, really. I was kind of like, well, it's a waste of my time. I can make $300 an hour playing, you know, on my computer, right? So why waste time entering the main event, right, when those fields were probably very, very soft. Now it's a tougher field, but it would still be a lot of fun. It'd be a great accomplishment.